Hello, I'm Fala again. Today we are going to be wiping the floors with aliens.
Hey, hi, hello everyone and welcome to another episode of XCOM Longer Impossible. Today we are going to Germany to stop an alien abduction. And we are prepped. I'm not taking any Master Sergeants with me because we are waiting for the people to come out of fatigue and the wounded states after the last base assault to attack the Exalt HQ. So, we are sending the next best thing and I'm hoping that this mission is going to go right.
Our target site is near the German border. Current updates from the ground indicate the aliens are moving within the city limits. We should get down there and secure the area as quickly as we can.
Okay, so this is going to be a small map. It's the rooftop construction, so I am expecting encountering the enemy right off the bat, because it's a swarming at alien attack, and that's gonna mean we will need to scramble.
This is Big Sky. Strike team has reached the AO. Requesting authorization to deploy.
Solid copy, Big Sky. Strike one is clear to engage.
And sure enough, just as I have gotten ready to move Aloysius to toss a battle scanner to the right, we have already encountered enemies waiting for us, which means we will deploy. We are going to take the best cover available and at the same time kill them fuckers. And so yeah, my plan right now is very simple. We are going to break down the guys, cover, eliminate them, then try to kill or otherwise disable the guy too far to the left, and we can't do really anything about the one who ran away, so we'll just let it slide. I don't really want to send pawns over there because it's gonna be rather dangerous. And Stigma would have a very good shot, but she cannot unfortunately shoot and move. So we are gonna have to resign from that for now, but nothing is lost, I hope. We need to get that big floater down. It's not a heavy, it's just a normal floater, but it's a boss, so we need to eliminate him. I guess I'm gonna have to take the risk with Pounce after all. He's a tank, so he's gonna be fine. And we didn't even activate any additional enemies, which is just damn great. We have 260s. Boop. And poop, Pounce does not fuck around. He's an awesome person and he destroys the floaters, eats them for breakfast and then goes for dinner. And who is next? Razor. Well, that was fucking awesome. I just took that shot for the very, you know, shits and giggles to see if it's gonna hit. And it actually has, which is very good. Okay. Okay, we hear more floaters. So there may be some enemies hiding to the right, but I don't think they are going to actually be all that dangerous to me right now, unless they decide to jump me, but there may be more enemies where I'm tossing the scanner, especially the floater who ran away, so I want to see what it's about to do, so I can prepare against it. And unfortunately, nobody can see it. Okay, so we are going to set up a defensive perimeter with a lot of overwatches and hope that he's going to run into me. Okay. Kratu has the arc rifle, so she has to steady. Everybody else is going to set up in position. So yeah, I think those little barrels are going to be my field of operation right now. And I don't really see what could go wrong against one floater. Unless something else decides to stomp into me, but I don't think that's gonna happen. Aliens have a tendency to activate in number when things are actually going a little tricky. Not where all we have to do is to eliminate a stray floater. And Annette actually hit something, so that's very surprising. So Annette breaks the stereotypes and we have Meldin to the right. That's fucking awesome. So I guess... damn it, I want to go for that Meld. I'm just not ready for it yet.
I'm keeping a lookout.
We're green to go.
We need to reload and prepare in order to actually be able to set up. Because I am really afraid that there may be aliens in that right darker corner. It's the most common surprise that the aliens are trying to pull off on this map, so I want to be careful. I will at least wait for the sound clue. Nothing yet.
Scanning.
Well, now I have Stigma in position. I should have moved her there last turn, but I didn't think about it. I guess we are gonna move out next turn for the meld on the right. I hope he's not gonna disappear. Aha, I knew it. Okay, so I'm going to send Aloysius to see what is there to see. We have the meld. And I'm gonna toss the battle scanner because we hear the aliens over there, so I'm not gonna pretend I don't. Okay, so we have a pack of seekers. That's well, it's very good that we have heard it right now rather than later, because that will allow me to get a jump on them with a molting bird's HE rocket rather than, you know, engaging on their enemies and then having them come to me. So yeah, that shot's gonna work. Oh yes, only one survivor, and that's a big one too. He's flanking us, so we will attack it up close. We are gonna send Pounce and Goliath to take care of it. And when Count Electric engages it, we are going to fire everything we have at it with holo targeting given by Annette. And we will protect the rest of the squad with the smoke grenade, set up Pounce and Count Electric forward so that it has no incentive to go against anybody else. And we are going to hopefully destroy that big thing. I don't know what they're called. They're big squids. Okay, Stigma unfortunately can't see them, and Kratu needs to set up the smoke. Boop. I love smoke grenades, they are saving my arse every single day. Just like well, they're I know that they are really just you know, ponies that are being mowed down into a fine dust of Pinkie Pie, but they are kind of like vodka. They save every day. They save lives. And now 96 is going to be completely taken by the damage reduction twice. So Pounce's attacks haven't done a single thing. And that's fucking hilarious. Oh crap. So yeah, that thing is rather dangerous, I'd say. And of course things gotten rather tricky, so we have 3 mutants and 2 mechtids coming to join the fun. And data blast. Ouch. Well fuck, that's not good. Okay, Aloysius is gonna move towards the Melden holo target, the guy on the way out from the corner of the container. Count is going to have to come closer and shoot straight up, and he's gonna have to fight that Titan squid all by himself. Let's pray that he actually hits it every now and again, because he needs to keep the squid occupied long enough for us to take care of it. Now Kratu has a disabling shot, 44% only because she's wounded, but she needs to hit it. And she does, fuck yes. Okay, so we are going to try to destroy one of the mectoids, I guess, but first I'm gonna... Why did I even bother? God damn it. Well, I have a soft spot. But anyway, we are going to need to damage one of the mechtoids as much as we possibly can, and that is very good. I want to disable one and let it leave, and then kill the other. I should have maybe thought about the shredder rocket before the hit, but then again, I got excited. And that's too bad, because otherwise we would have perhaps one-shotted that bastard. But anyway, what's done is done. Let's move on. That's what happens when you let your reflexes decide. Because it's a bad idea, basically. You need to always think about your decisions before you make them, otherwise things Understood, happen. Sir. Like, for example, shoot a sniper, critical fire, precision shot, I'm sorry, without shredding the target beforehand. Well, at least we are going to maybe get the meld. I don't know, we have to destroy this guy. Now the other mectoid is disabled, so he's going to come close to us using the support of the mutants, so I'm a little wary about the one in the front, but the squid is in my back and the smoke grenade is going to stop working very soon. What do I do? I don't need to panic the mectoid. This is a mutant sentry. This guy is the mectoid, disabled, don't care. So 60. Yeah, I guess.
Your death is only the beginning.
Okay, your death is only the beginning, and then the panic failed. Well, fuck that. I hope that they are not going to shoot a grenade at me. I don't think they will, but I think they are mutants are going to support the mectoid while the mectoid moves in to attack us twice from close proximity next turn. At least that's what the aliens are thinking, and that's what I want them to think. Okay, now reload. Now this guy's gonna go and suppress probably somebody, I hope. Okay. So now I am not expecting a grenade, but instead the mutant actually comes close. Okay, so we are going to have to use the goat grenade because I don't see a choice.
They're shooting at me here.
They are trying to suppress me, which doesn't matter. As long as they don't shoot me, and the meld is gone. So, oh yeah, that's great, Alloy Jesus destroyed the big squida. So we can actually get a move on and do something useful.
Understood, sir.
That's very good, we have the goat grenade in range now. I shudder to think what would happen if Aloysius would miss, but I had to take my chances. Otherwise I would not be able to free Count Electric, and I need Count Electric to come and deal with the mectoid next turn. And that's about it, basically. Now we need the Annette to toss that grenade to disable one of the suppressions and break partially the cover of the Muton. Only partially, I don't want to break my own cover. We are going to then shred them all. Actually, maybe just gonna use the normal rocket. And that's going to stop the second suppression also and free my people, so I can try to damage them as much as I possibly can. I will be then using the goat grenade to hide them at people on the left and smoke grenade to hide people on the right. And that's about everything I can possibly do. I'm hoping that Pounce is going to take the majority of the damage because he is equipped to deal with it. And Count Electric is gonna follow in kind. I don't think anyone's going to actually shoot him. Everybody's gonna shoot Pounce. And that sets me up to take care of the mectoid next turn. Count Electric is going to power fist him in the face. And that's about it. So I'm going to set a smoke. I'm going to give it to Pounce also, because he's going to be the best available target anyway. And this is my plan. At least that's the plan A. Now Goat Grenade is going to hide people, which means that the mutants are going to go and try to get a flank. I'm sorry, and try to get a flank on Pounce next turn, which we are going to use well and simply massacre them when they are up close. And that's the best we can do, really. Okay, plan is working. Now Pounce is gonna get flanked, so I hope he doesn't get fucking hit. Okay, he did. Well, bloody hell. I'm sorry, Pounce, but you have to be my bullet sponge. Okay. Okay. There you go.
Taking fire over here.
That's right, see? Pounce is great as a SpongeBob and he takes care of the damage with ease. He is as good a tank as he is a tactician. You should check out his channel and see for yourself if you haven't already. And now we are going to see if the Mectoid has some prostate problems with our field prostate exam. As you see, there was nothing to find and we have checked thoroughly. Now, unfortunately, that pistol didn't really do all that much, but now Razor can kill all the Xenos if she hits. Okay. Razor does not fuck around, ever. I've checked. In any way, Pounce will have to now retreat and get healed, because he is on the last legs. Fuck yeah, check Stigma out. Oh yeah. That mutant didn't stand a chance. Now we get Alloy Jesus, which means we will have to wait for the remaining alien to come to us. Unfortunately, I can't reach him right now, but that's why we have the two tanks on this mission. I was expecting close quarters, so I came prepared for close quarters. We have enough tanks to take care of everything, and Aloysius is gonna mark this target. Okay.
Shot did not connect.
And Razor is gonna kill all the Xenos. Razor is gonna kill all the Xenos. Okay, then somebody else can kill them. Razor likes to share. Come on, Beagle. Bungle, I'm sorry. I can't read.
Moving out.
See, that's why I don't like Annette. She has a weird nickname that is hard to read for me. And a weird voice. Okay, so we can't really reach that bugger, so I hope that 23 is gonna maybe hit. Yeah, I didn't expect that to happen either. But we have nothing better, we have to unload at this guy and hope that he is eventually going to fall. There is no other choice, we can always use a rocket to get rid of him. I guess maybe we should. On the other hand, that's a huge waste of a rocket, so I'm gonna try to psy-panic him, so he doesn't try to do anything stupid in his own turn. Your death is only the beginning. Damn, Nanette is pissing me off. In any way, that at least gives me a moment to survive and, well, try to kill him next turn. We are going to have to take him down with the sheer firepower, because we can't destroy him cover and I do not dare going for a flank, thanks to the unknown territory over there. I simply do not know what is awaiting me there and I hear floaters, so I don't want to just dash my people for a possible flank and just to activate another pod. We are going to have to do it the old-fashioned way. It's at least panicking, so it won't shoot back. That's a good thing, right? And Stigma is going to get him, isn't she? Nope. Well, as much as the solution, I am forced to choose lacks elegance. And, well, quite frankly, I would really avoid doing that unless I was shooting a panicked target. But we simply do not have a choice. And fuck, Annette is on a roll today. I'm gonna get you. I love you. I still don't like you, Annette. Okay, so now we can start and use the containers on the left to set up a nice L-shaped formation to destroy the enemies with. So we are going to use the containers to get Aloysius forward and everybody else is going to follow, whilst Alloy Jesus has led the way. And we are going to set the people by the containers and by the elevation to the right in order to get everything done. I'm just going to get everybody ready for Shizzle so that nothing bad happens. Okay, pounds can be dashed over there already, it's safe. And I don't think the floaters are going to actually come to me, which means we are going to follow with the plan. No more surprises await us, which is great. And now I'm gonna have to sneak around, which is gonna take a lot of time, but well, I have all day, don't I? Okay, now Annette Bungle Durand is gonna go over there. Okay, we are going to expect them somewhere around there, which means I do have some freedom of movement. But, you know, overconfidence kicked me in the balls way too many times for me to just dash into that situation. It was simply going too easy. Okay, it's far from easy because we already have wounded people, and if not for the goat grenade, we would be in trouble, but that's still not the opposition I was expecting. It's the second year, and I don't really know what kind of strengths aliens are going to show to me, so I do have to be careful. As much as it kills me inside. In any way, Alloy Jesus is on the way. I'm gonna set up everybody to follow in kind so that they can open fire as soon as we meet enemies. Headed there now. I am fully expecting them to just come out of the fog of war and try to fuck us in the eyeball at any moment. The very second I drop my guard just for that additional tile of speed, they're going to come. I feel it in my fingers. I feel it in my bones. The floaters all around me, they're never gonna let it go. Okay, I can't sing and I'm gonna stop before, you know, you die in front of your computers. With your ears bleeding from my horrible harpy wails.
I don't think we're alone out here.
No, we are not alone out here. There are elves and Protestants.
On the move.
Okay, so that's not gonna activate any floaters, which means we have the ability to move forward. I guess I'm gonna have to reconsider. I'm gonna send somebody else on Aloysius' place. For example, Annette for now, she has holo targeting, and Alloy Jesus is gonna be more important for me moving onwards. And Annette is gonna be replaced by Razor soon, while we simply push forward, chopping away at the hiding spots the aliens can possibly take. Scanning. I expect to find them around the pipes, but as I said, overconfidence has costed me a lot every now and again, so we will try to avoid being overconfident for once. I can be careful when I want to, god damn it. Okay, so seems like this is gonna be the safest possible route. I can get Annette over there, perhaps. I would rather it not be a dash, but fuck it. It's only Annette. If she dies, she dies. Now we put a Razor in her place. Razor is gonna be able to open effective fire from there next turn if need be. Stigma now has a pretty nice view on that box. And we are as safe as we are going to get this turn. Well, I half expect 50 sectopods just show themselves out of nowhere, because goddamn, I was careful. So something must happen. And I don't really want to risk going with Molting Bird up that roof, but this is gonna be a safe spot. She's not gonna be flanked in there, so everything's going to be fine. Okay, so we hear the floaters behind that concrete box, and we are going to now set up on the pipe. to release them from their suffering next turn and just kill them.
Headed there now.
If they are normal floaters, then sitting in one place like this doesn't matter. If they are heavy, we are gonna have to spread out a little bit so that they don't shoot a grenade at in our faces. And since they are behind the concrete box, I would like to be able to activate them with a very nice rocket. So Molting Bird's gonna go over here. Annette... Yeah, fuck on it, she can just stay where she is. And that's where we are going to be. We are gonna break the box with a rocket next turn. And we don't even have to, that's nice, they came out. They probably sensed me sneaking up on them. And those are heavy floaters, so we are gonna have to spread out. Unfortunately, our overwatches did not land a hit, but that's fine. Not every shot must be a hit, and not every action must be successful. And that actually is even better for me, because now the rocket we intended to activate them with can break their cover and damage them and be even awesomer, so that's very good. We are going to break that cover with a rocket as planned, and then we are going to desecrate their corpses, we are going to piss on them, and then boil their corpses and make tea in the cups that we make from their skulls. I think that's a good plan, eh? Unfortunately, not all the cover was broken. I guess that's fine. I want Annette to holo target the guy who is flying for me, because we need that chances to hit. Now, Razor is going to kill all the Xenos. Okay. Those are the... Nice! Those are the three things that every Razor must do in their life. Kill a floater, kill a sectoid, kill a squirrel. And now Stigma is gonna mark the flyer for me. That was a very nice shot. 40. I may want to come a little closer. That way we will only see the flyer, the other guy is gonna be out of sight. And we will be able to drop it. Drop the base. But yeah, Kratos doesn't want to stay there, obviously. We have the Melda's full cover, which we are going to utilize. And as much as I think the chem grenade would be fun, we can't really do it. But we can try to mind fray. If it's gonna work, it's gonna be cool. If it's not gonna work, then nothing's gonna change. So that's why we've done it rather than shoot. And yeah, nothing's gonna change. I'm gonna set Pounce with a run and gun on the concrete wall, and I will open fire on that bugger. Pounce is a tank, he can take it. Rapid fire! Boom, nice! And the second one hit also, but it was not enough to kill. That's probably because we are using a scatter laser, because the alloy cannons are broken. And yeah, only the armor has been zinched. Pounce doesn't give a fuck. He's the man who eats nails for breakfast and then drinks down with molten glass. So, what's a heavy floater? Now we have a holo on it, and actually, why not? Let's have Pounce have the kill. And that's a tank assault, everybody. Everything by the numbers. So yeah, basically, thanks to Goat Grenade and Pounce, we have managed to return home without too many wounded people. Kratu has been severely damaged, but not due to any tactical mistake we've made, it simply because she was simply sniped out of smoke by the bastard mechtoid. We can't really control it. So yeah, Aloysius can choose between bring him on within the zone, is gonna be a nice combo, or Sprinter. If you want, I can also give you tactical sense, but I don't see why. Kratu is out for 29 days. I guess that's pretty sad, but hey, you have a free vacation that is paid full time. And marshmallows.
We will be in touch, Commander.
Okay, time to repair the equipment. Are we going to do anything with the foundry? I don't really think so. Ammo conservation might be of useful. Can we get anything else? We can take the Wing Dick Sparrowhawks, but that's a very bad foundry project. So I'm going to gather 500 cash and get the ammo conservation, because we are going to need it with the Gauss long rifles, which we are going to be using for a while since we are skipping pools. 20 mutant corpses I must keep. Wasn't it 26 not long ago? I guess they changed that in the latest beta. Mutant captives, I can sell them, I don't really need them, but I do want to exchange them with the council, so we are gonna keep them for now. Plus, we have to get rid of the trash from the base somehow, and that way we save on the sanitary firm. We just have to throw all the refuse to the zoo where we keep our aliens, right? Okay, I cancel. Maybe.
I think we can take them.
Of course we can take them. First we take them to the zoo, and then to the circus, and then maybe to see some movies, Bradford. Come on. Okay, we need 25 more credits, and I don't really see any. I don't want to sell mutant captives. I have 10 of them, but I want to Sectoid Commander. One of them, maybe. Alloys never meld. Yeah, we are gonna be good with meld. It's not a lot, and we are going to attack alien bases again, so we're gonna get pack loads of meld anyway. And ammo conservation is on the way.
I'll make sure to notify you as soon as production is finished.
And we are researching things, so now 10 heavy floater corpses for 2 engineers. That's tempting, but I'm not sure if I need heavy floater corpses for something. Do I or don't I? I don't remember. Anyway, Catalina Huerta has tested positive for Psy. And now we're only waiting for Cucumber. By the way, if any of you guys want to be a Psy operative, just let me know. We have lots of free people. I'm gonna send Zhang in there as soon as the alien HQ is taken care of. I don't see. Maybe. Nah. Okay.
Aircraft transfer complete.
And Cucumber Dragon has reached the second level of Psy. And let's keep scanning. Aegis armor is complete. Very good. And we still have to wait 3 days before we can attack the Exalt HQ. Fine with me. Plasma weapons research is complete. Very good. Very awesome. We can now soon start working on our plasma carbines. I'm thinking right after we take the Exalt HQ. Plasma carbines are better than my Gauss rifles, and so are storm guns, so we may build some of them also. Now, compact plasma weapons. I will need them for plasma pistols at some point. I need 2 plasma pistols for people who are going to be carrying the arc rifles. Now, combat exoskeletons are going to be very important for me later, but first I need advanced plasma weapon, because we need plasma rifles. And after that we are going to take care of stuff that we desperately need to take care of. Now, we can't really build the plasma carbines yet, we can't really build anything now. Right now I don't have anything to sell, except for those poor mutant captives which I want to keep for now. So we are waiting to attack Exalt HQ, and that is going to solve my money problems for a while.
Additional workshop online.
Okay. Stuff gets repaired. And please tell me that I have my Master Sergeant's pack. Mini Falag is still out of commission. And the restorative mist is complete. We have the advanced repair finally, so our interceptors are going to be more operational from now on, and our ships are also going to get fixed faster, and so will our mechs. And the Mini Falag is still out of commission. But for 15 hours, and I bloody need that mayhem suppression, so we will wait. Skeleton keys are ready. We don't have satellites yet, so we can't really utilize them. Heavy floater captive for scientists? Sure, why not? And the request has timed out, which is, I guess, fine with me. And now we know that, by the way, those fuckers have been hiding in Japan all along, right on top of our base.
Exalt base location identified.
That's it, Commander. Based on the compiled intelligence reports, we've confirmed the location of Exalt's primary base. We can launch an assault against the facility on your order.
Yep, those fuckers were hiding on top of my head all the time. In any way, I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. If so, let me know in the comments, like the video, and I will see you again in the next episode. Bye-bye!